So in the last episode, I gave a quick preview of the key functionalities of the Google Docs. So I gave a quick preview of the menu items. And also there are this toolbar icons which you can actually use also to enhance the functionality of the Google Docs. So in today's episode, I want to now finish this CD project. And one of the design we are going to use is the one-page CV design, and which is again mostly recommended by most recruiters. So they don't really want you to put a lot of details in your CV, so they just want the basic one. The details you can put maybe in your LinkedIn page. So for this, we are going to use what we call a template. So a template is basically a layout which defines how a document can be established. And for this case, they're going to use a CV template, a one-page CV template. And to go to templates, what you need to go to do is go to File, under New, you say From Templates. So basically, you choose a document from a template. So it will open up a page where you can actually browse through the different templates which are available. And let me just give you some quick preview of the templates available. So there are reports. Maybe if you're writing a report which is based on APA, you can choose an APA report. This one is a resume if you are writing a CV. Projects, reports, class notes, even if you're working on an MLA-based report. So if your document should be formatted to MLA, then you choose the MLA report. So there are different types of resumes, so there are different colors. You pick your brand color. You can also write letters. So if you are writing maybe a cover letter, you can pick from these different designs or templates. Then also these ones are personal templates. Like if someone has prepared for you a recipe, or you want to prepare for someone a recipe, then you can easily type it in this document and share with them so they can have their nice meal. Again, these ones are related to professional work. So if, for example, if you are in the software development world, normally you write project proposal, or for any project you are dealing with, normally you write proposal. So with this template, you can actually get a well-defined project proposal which you can actually start editing right away. So if you are doing projects, remember you will always have to have meetings, or any general meeting you can have, you can always have these templates and use them. Then there are also templates on onboarding. So if you are a new recruit or you are a recruitment department and you want an onboarding notes, so you can actually get the templates from there. Newsletters are also important for maybe sending company-wide information or any news. Then you can also write mutual NDAs. So NDAs are non-disclosure agreements. Normally you write them for legal purposes. Then if you're in consultancy industry and you have to set up some agreement with the client, so you can also get templates about that. So, and also in sales, you can get software development proposals. So when you're designing software, you normally start with some proposal. Requests for proposals are those documents used in procurement, majorly if you want people to maybe to tender on some procurement order. So you prepare a request for proposal document where they can submit their quotes. So there are a bunch of different templates, so you can always explore them, and if you feel this one you want to use, you can actually just click it. So let's say, for example, our CV project, so and we want a one-page CV, so we'll take the one with this design, the one called Serif. So if you click it, it will open up the template in a new Word document called Resume, so you can rename it My CV. And now you are now able to start editing. So on the left panel, you get the outline of the document. So there are various sections like experience, education, projects, skills, awards, and languages. So basically, you just start writing now. So you highlight that one. If you want to remove that part, call maybe. So you give some maybe career goal. Career objectives. Maybe to be a professor. at MIT, then you put your work experience. So let's say you start with a company, then you start with the one which are currently, you are currently working on a very recent job. Then you just start, you highlight that part company and you start typing. So let's say Komazo. Then if you want to set the location, you highlight, double click it, it will highlight the location. Then you just put the location, Kilifi. Then job title, you highlight it by right clicking and dragging the with the mouse, then you just put your title. Then it also you can put the month you started working in that company, the year. Then you put maybe what you are doing. So yeah, you don't have to include much details. So remember, like I said, the CV these days they want it to be in one page. So you try to limit what you really put. So most of the details you can actually include in my LinkedIn page. Then you go to company tour. So let's say ICT Authority. So you give a location, Nairobi. And you give a total standards officer. Then you give the month where you started working at that company. Basically, you repeat what you did here for maybe for 3 jobs or roles. Camry, maybe CDC. So you give location. And your title, you can give a right support. Then you just repeat the same with the current, the things you were doing at that workplace. Then in education also, you just need to give the at least the degree or master's or maybe PhD you have. So you give the name of the university, Maseno. So you give it the location. It's a degree, then you give the date you started at that university and the date maybe you graduated. Then maybe high school, if you don't have any diploma you did before the degree, you can include the high school diploma. So maybe, then you can remove the location and put the location of the school, so you can say Mumbai. So this one was high school diploma. Then you put the details. Then you can also include the projects you've done, maybe in the past if you did some projects at the university or at work. So you can actually include them here for all the recruiters to see them. So then you give the details of that project. Maybe you can also put maybe GitHub links to that project so they can check it out. So you can give maybe 1 or 2 projects. Then skills, yes, now here you can actually now include your technical expertise, like what skills you have. Maybe you can say web development, database design. Let's say project management. And the data analysis. So you can give skills, the major skills you have, then awards, maybe the awards you received, you can now include them here if you receive some certifications or some acknowledgements. Languages, you can either put the technical languages or the linguistic languages. So let's say for programmers or developers, you can include the technical languages like PHP, maybe Python, Java, JavaScript. They are main. So basically, with this now, you can, if you check, you want to see maybe where it is saved, and you can click File, Move. So you want to rearrange maybe the storage place for this file. So by default, it goes into my drive, but not in a particular folder or a directory. So to move it, you just want to click it to my CV. Then you just click move. So it will be moved to that my CV folder, and you can actually undo it here also. Or just dismiss that notification. So once that is done, also you can also put your addresses here. So let's say maybe 123 Kilifi. So you put the city name Kilifi. Then you can also even input your email address so that maybe the recruiter can actually email you on the details of the job. Then you can also include your LinkedIn page. So you can just go to www.linkedin.com/in, then you put your profile name. So the recruiter will be able to, if they click on the link, then it will take them to your actual LinkedIn page, where they can now get the details of your work experiences, what you're up to, the projects you've done. So basically LinkedIn is now a more expanded version of the CV. That's why these days you should always limit your CV to at least just one page is enough. Then if you're done now, remember everything saves automatically, so you don't need to worry. And again, if you are having maybe, you want to edit it maybe over the phone, you can always actually download the Google Drive app for Android, and the files will be synced to your mobile phone, so you don't have to worry of the location. So anywhere you are, maybe you can always edit it or share it with the other people. But normally for printing purposes, it's always good to have your CV ready in the PDF format. So PDF is a format for printing. So to do that, now you go to file, then you say download, then you say PDF. So that one means it will be downloaded as PDF. So basically, with that comes to the end of this introduction to templates. So like I've said, you can always play with the templates available. So if you want to access template, you just go to file, then you create new, then you say from template. So it will give you an avalanche of templates to choose from. And you can always, maybe also if you want a template that you can't see in the templates available, you can always search for that specific template. So let's say you are doing a software design, maybe documentation. So just say software design documentation, then you say template, Google Docs. So by saying Google Docs, the search engine will know you want a Google Docs template, not any other. And one of them you will see is, and this is even a good provided by Google. So if you click it, it will open for you a sample template to you can now actually edit. So normally they share their templates in view mode, so you can't edit it. So for you to edit it, you can actually make a copy of this document. And even in the instruction, you are told, make a copy. And you go to file, make a copy. So it means you are duplicating this document. So you can now choose where you want to store it. So you browse the folder you want to store it. Then you just click OK. So it will create a duplicate copy of that, and with this one now you have edit access. You can actually start editing by removing this instruction. And now you have a complete document to work with. So this is now a complete software design document, one of the deliverables in any software design. So remember, you don't have to save it, it saves automatically. And if you want to change maybe the colors, you can always change with the color, text color icon. So if you are a person who is always green, you can use the green. So always go with your brand color, maybe for your company, to ensure there's brand consistency. So with that comes to the end of today's lesson. And in the next episode, we are going to look into another key component of Google Docs, that is the the add-ons. So add-ons are actually an important functionality of Google Docs. It enables you to extend the current functionality of Google Docs. For example, let's say you want to email a document to a large number of people, and you want to each email to be customized to their maybe their details, so like mail merging. So that is an example of where now you need an add-on to enable you to do the functionality much more easier without having to redesign maybe a new add-on or come up with your own. So with that comes to the end of our episode, and see you next time. Always remember to subscribe to the channel so that you can always get updated on the new episodes. And if you have any suggestions or comments, you can always leave them in the comment below. Thank you, and see you next time.